Good morning. We're going to start learning now the laws of Yom Kippur, starting with Erev Yom Kippur, Erev Yom Kippur, which is going to be next week on Tuesday. Tuesday night is Yom Kippur, all the way till Wednesday night. It's a fast that starts from the night and goes to the next night. So for Erev Yom Kippur, again, we had the tradition to do Hatarat Nedarim, to annul the vows, Erev Yom Kippur, but we also add in the part of Hatarat Kelalot. So it's a little bit longer, and again, we'll be doing that Bezat Hashem on Tuesday morning after Shacharit. The next tradition is that it's also nice, if possible, to go to the Bet HaKvarot, to go to the cemetery, the Eid of Yom Kippur, similar to the way we went Erev Rosh Hashanah, and also to the Arbot Bitzdaka, to give as much charity as possible. That is a very special day, Erev Yom Kippur. The next halakha is that the Talmud learns specifically from the Torah, from the verses, the way the Torah describes both the days, the 9th and the 10th of the month, that on the 9th of the month we are supposed to also have inui, have some pain or some suffering. The Talmud learns that obviously God does not want us to fast for 48 hours straight. Rather, we're supposed to eat a lot, eat to the point where it almost hurts, where it does hurt, on the 9th of the month of Tishrei. So we go into the fast bloated and really, really full. And the Talmud says that a person who eats a lot on the 9th and fasts on the 10th, it's as if they fasted, they have the merit of fasting both days. Therefore, the Talmud takes, in halakha, we take it quite seriously, that there is a mitzvah to eat on the eve of Yom Kippur as much as possible. Eating, drinking. We know great Talmid Chachamim that they would be, back in the day, they would be chewing on nuts and raisins all day long, so it's a continuous mitzvah. Or a sucking candy, something that is eating all day, that brings the mitzvah to a greater level. Now obviously, there's eating in quantity, but also eating throughout the day is something which is very, very nice. There are those that have a minimum of 2 bread meals on the day, and according to the Ben Ishchai, you should have 5 bread meals on the day. Now that's literally going to take you all day. But again, if you could do 1 or 2, that would be a beautiful thing. It would be the proper thing to do. Sudam Afsekit anyways is your Hamotzi. So if you could do a Shacharit, Pat Shacharit, you could do a breakfast with Hamotzi, at least you get 2 meals in, and that would be great. Now, that, as hard as it might be, is still palatable. Listen to the next halakha. There's 2 days in the year, besides for Yom Tovs, and besides for Hol HaMoed, that there is an Isur Melacha, that we're not allowed to work. And, I guess you could have guessed, that one of those days is Erev Yom Kippur. The other day is Erev Pesach. Okay, so besides for Tisha B'Av, but I'm saying, besides for holidays themselves, the eves of holidays, only Erev Pesach and Erev Yom Kippur have a prohibition of working. Now, why do we have prohibition of working Erev Yom Kippur? Because we are to involve ourselves completely in eating as much as we can. Can you imagine? Therefore, Chachamim said, we should not go to work on Erev Yom Kippur. And lo aleinu, anyone who goes to work on Yom Kippur, eno ro'eh siman beracha klal. This is the terminology, I'm not making it up. So a person would not see blessing from the work that they go to work on the eve of Yom Kippur. Now, having said that, if you are working and you have a 9-to-5 job, or you have to put in so many hours a week, lo aleinu, you might get fired or penalized tremendously by your employer, then you go to work, but you're not going to see any bracha that happens on that day. You're going to see bracha de Baruch Hashem, you won't get fired. And it's a valid, there's an allowance. If a person will be fired or have tremendous loss by not going to work on the eve of Yom Kippur, they can go. It's not ideal, but they could go. However, just be sure not to do anything too important, because whatever is going to be done on that day, lo aleinu, there won't be any siman beracha. So again, no work, eating as much as we can. It's said that also Talmidei Chachamim who study all day, who do a lot of mitzvot, also need to, so to say, cut back on that the eve of Yom Kippur and go and make sure to eat and drink as much as possible. Zat Hashem HaKadosh Baruch Hu will accept our tefillot, amen. Accept our fast, and we'll have a teshuvah shema. Amen. Tonight,